Hello everyone, and welcome to the CSS Security Mini Briefing, where we will present a short summary of what was released today, September 12th, 2023. My name is Josh Daniel, and I'm a risk manager in the customer service and support organization here at Microsoft. We're going to start this video with an overview of the release, and then we'll dive into a few of the vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities we are covering in this video may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the security update guide. Now, before I dig into today's release, I like to compare it to the previous 12 months to see how this release stacks up with the previous year's worth of releases. And this month, we have a total of 61 new vulnerabilities that were published, which is a little bit lower than our average of around 77. There were 24 remote code execution vulnerabilities in today's release, and we've been averaging just around 27 and a half. Next, I'll move on to scoring, where Microsoft uses the industry standard Common Vulnerability Scoring System, or CVSS. This is a scale between 1 and 10 that allows vendors to compare the risk of different vulnerabilities across different products. And this month, the highest rated CVSS score in the 61 total vulnerabilities comes out to 8.8 on that scale of 10. And it breaks a string of 7 months in a row where that high point was at 9.8, so down to 8.8 for September. When we look at the average score across all 61 new vulnerabilities, the average comes in at 7.36, which is right about the average of what we've been seeing over the past 13 months. There was one publicly disclosed vulnerability in yesterday's set, and we've been averaging just under one per release, and there are two vulnerabilities known to be exploited at the time of release, and we've been averaging just under two over the past 13 months. Now onto our overview side, where we put the Windows products that are serviced every single month towards the bottom, and then as we move up the chart, we get into products that are not serviced every single month, and that's certainly the case here with the Windows products towards the bottom. And in regards to the Windows products, we've been averaging between mid-30s and mid-40s, depending on the exact operating system, with the newer versions averaging in the mid-40s and the older versions, such as 2012, averaging in the mid-30s. And as we can see this month, it's well below average for the Windows products. We've been averaging 8 vulnerabilities in the Office set, and there are 7 this month, so just under average there. There are a handful of vulnerabilities in Microsoft Exchange Server that are documented in September, but were actually part of the release in August. So if you installed the August Exchange Security Update, you've already addressed those newly disclosed CVEs, so there's no action items for you. If you have not installed the August Security Update for Exchange, then there are a handful of vulnerabilities, the ones that were disclosed in August, as well as these 5 that are being published in September. You're vulnerable to all of those in August and September. So if you are using Exchange, please make sure you can update your environment as soon as you can. Continuing to move upward, we get into .NET Framework and Visual Studio, and .NET 6 and 7, of course, are there as well, with a handful of vulnerabilities being addressed this month. Dynamics 365 has 3 vulnerabilities this month. There's Azure HD Insight, Azure Kubernetes Service, Azure DevOps Server, and rounding it all out is Windows Defender. All right, so let's dive into the first vulnerability that I'll cover in this video. This is CVE-2023-36802. This is an important elevation of privilege vulnerability in the streaming service proxy. This was privately disclosed to Microsoft. However, exploitation has been detected on this vulnerability. This has a base score of 7.8. The attack vector is local. The attack complexity is low. Privileges are required for this, low privileges, but no user interaction is required to leverage this vulnerability. As far as mitigations or workarounds, there are no published mitigations or workarounds. And as far as affected software, it's the newer versions of Windows that are in support, whether it's desktop 10 and 11 and server 2019 and 2022. Next, I'll talk to CVE-2023-38148. This is a critical remote code execution vulnerability in the internet connection sharing service. This one was privately disclosed to Microsoft with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a base score of 8.8, so it's right at the top of what we're seeing this month. The attack vector is adjacent, the attack complexity is low, privileges required is none, and user interaction here is none. There's no documented workarounds for this, but as far as mitigations, systems are only vulnerable to this if they have ICS enabled, which is not a default configuration. So if you haven't enabled internet connection sharing, then that system will not be vulnerable to this. As far as affected software, it's Windows 10 and 11 and Server 2022. And next we'll move on to the office space where we have CVE-2023-36761, which is an important information disclosure vulnerability. This one was publicly disclosed and exploitation has been detected. It has a base score of 6.2, which on its own we probably wouldn't be discussing, but again, because of those publicly disclosed and exploitation detected flags, that raises the severity of this vulnerability. It doesn't raise the CVSS score, but it does raise the overall risk. The attack vector is local, the attack complexity is low, privileges required is none, and user interaction here is also none. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this vulnerability. As far as affected software, it's Word 2013, Word 2016, Office Long-Term Servicing Channel 2021, Office 2019, and 365 Apps Enterprise. Okay, that is it for the vulnerabilities that I will cover today. I want to thank everyone for tuning in, and I'll talk to you all next month.